at a very dangerous moment in our history and in the history of the world. To address you on the subject of implications of a Zionist-Israeli attack on Iran, which now appears to be not only fairly certain, but also just around the corner. We say that Israel wants to attack Iran because Israel ultimately wants to rule the world. Because the Zionists want to rule the world. Because the Judeo-Christian Zionist European Alliance wants to deliver to the state of Israel the status of ruling state in the world. That's why we believe all these wars are taking place. And so this is why they want to attack Iran. You have the right to wage war against the people unjustly. And so an attack on Iran would be unjust war. But I want to say something more. To those who are beating the drums of war in the Arab world and who are looking forward to the attack on Iran, that you are beating the drums of unjust war. And when the attack takes place, you will be committing the same sin as supporters of the war, as those who are themselves perpetrating the war. And shame on you! Shame on you, we say to you, straight to your faces, from here in Malaysia, that if you support the attack on Iran, you are supporting unjust war. You are yourselves a party of Zulm. And Allah does not provide guidance to the people who commit Zulm. One of the reasons why many Arabs get in a larger framework in which those who are waging war on Islam are seeking to do something that will function as a catalyst for creating Sunni Shia civil war in the world of Islam. Sunni Shia civil war would be something that would be massively beneficial for Israel. Number one, Sunni Shia civil war will make Islam look negatively, a negative image in the world. At a moment when Islam is center stage in the attention of the whole world. Number two, Sunni Shia civil war in Islam, Sunni versus Shia, would function as a diversion, diverting attention, both Muslim and non-Muslim attention, away from the plans of the Zionists to rule the world. Thirdly, Muslims fighting against themselves will obviously lead to a loss of power. Our power will decrease, and that will be strategically advantageous for Israel. War on Iran obviously is going to impact on the world economy. Number one, on the price of oil. Not only because Iran is a major supplier of oil, but also because Iran is located in that basin that the Iranians call the Persian Gulf and the Arabs call the Arab Gulf, and they're still fighting over the words. The price of oil is going to shoot up because Iran can also block the Straits of Hormuz. It's in our Iranian territory on this side of Oman on that side. It's not difficult for Iran to block the Straits of Hormuz and disrupt all the passage of oil tankers. So we can anticipate fairly confidently that the price of oil is going to escalate dramatically once the attack takes place. And the American government knows that. And that's why the American government does not want Iran to be attacked. Because the American government knows, and the Federal Reserve knows, and the bankers also know, that the US dollar is going to collapse. It will not survive an Israeli attack on Iran with the price of oil shooting up through the roof. And if the US dollar collapses, of course, they're going to have to demonetize the US dollar. It will no longer be legal tender. They have to have something in place. They probably already have something to replace it, but at a fraction of its previous value. The American economy is going to collapse. Large numbers of white Americans are going to lose their wealth. And many of them are going to be listening to this lecture. There's going to be chaos in the United States when the economy collapses. There can be riots in the United States, and they're already anticipating that. And so an attack on Iran would lead to economic, financial, and monetary consequences that would be disastrous for the U.S.